All right, so we did talk about linear perspective, and I'm going to show you a few tips and tricks for drawing architecture and linear perspective. So traditionally, we would be out in the hallway and looking at the scenery in the hallways to draw. And starting with the most simplest scene, if I'm looking straight ahead at a wall, so let's say here's the wall, and walls are definitely square or rectangular. This one's going to be rectangular. So here is the rectangular wall that I'm looking straight ahead at. This is one point perspective. And let's say I'm standing. So if I'm imagining myself all the way across the hallway and I'm standing there, my head would be right about here, and maybe that is where my vanishing point is. So your vanishing point is typically where your line of sight is. So if say there were a mirror all the way down the hallway and you were looking at yourself, it's wherever your eye lands. So if this is where my head is while I'm standing across the hallway, bang, that's my vanishing point. However, if I'm standing over to the side right here, the vanishing point will change to over here. And the difference is very drastic. So let's say my vanishing point is right there. I'm standing in the middle of the hallway looking straight down. If I connect this to this corner, there's the line for where the ceiling and the wall meet. And then there's this line right here. That's where that line meets. And then these are going to be more angled downwards. And then right here. So, whoops. Yeah. So right there. So that's that. Those are my four corners of my room, based on my line of sight standing up. Now this changes. Let's see how this changes. If I am standing on the right-hand side and my line of sight is here, then my angle is going to connect from here to here. And so this is going to be much more drastic going up higher. And this one definitely more drastic going much lower. So you can see the difference where, like, I'm seeing less of this wall because I'm on this side of the hallway, and then I'm going to be able to see more of that side. So let's see what that looks like. So this is going to be this way, and then this one will be that way. So it looks really wonky if you're on one side of the wall instead of directly in the middle, but a much more interesting composition than, having the lines going crisscrossing just like that. So, a much more interesting design for sure. So here is a wall with a dead end that you're looking at, and you're standing on the right side. So vanishing points really matter, and where you're standing really matters, or sitting, or wherever, whatever it is you're looking at really matter.